Kevin Wardell is a Louisvillian with a full agenda. Along with his duties as the Chief Administrative Officer of the Norton Cancer Institute, he's also president of the Rotary Club of Louisville. And he joins us now to discuss Rotary's role in education and workforce initiatives. Welcome.
I'm glad to be here.
Well, I'm going to start with Rotary. First of all, to people who might not know, explain what Rotary is and what it does.
Rotary is a club that's composed of business and civic leaders that is committed to service in the community. Our motto is service above self, and that's the kind of people we look for. And here in Louisville, we're the ninth largest club in the world out of 32,000. Wow. We have about 450 members, and there are about 1.2 million members worldwide.
In 2012, as part of Rotary's centennial, the club established the Rotary Promise Scholarships. Mm-hmm. What are those?
Well, that was a vision of Henry Heiser, who was our president at the time. And the idea of the Rotary Promise Scholarship is to take poor performing high schools in the public school system and to guarantee every student that enters those as freshmen and meets certain criteria that they'll have a full two-year scholarship to Jefferson Community Technical College upon graduation.
How did you select the students that you were helping? I mean, how did you get to the point of saying, okay, these are the ones we're going to really help?
Well, we worked with the school superintendent's office to identify the high schools, which mm-hmm. are Western and Iroquois High School at the present time. We hope to expand that longer term. Every student is eligible when they enter those high schools. To receive the scholarship, they need to maintain a 2.5 average, good behavior, and good attendance. And then they are eligible at the end to when they matriculate to JCTC for a full scholarship.
Mm-hmm. The scholarship is in line with the American Graduate Initiative, which is KET is part of that. Why is it key, do you think, to address a dropout crisis in our area?
Well, I think it's important from a workforce perspective, and I speak in the business sense of our own workforce mm-hmm. requirements, that we have a very educated workforce and we can't leave anyone behind. That's the point of the 55,000 Degrees program. And our view with this particular program is to provide that opportunity for everyone to get into an educational environment that will produce a middle class income.
American Graduate aims to improve education from childhood all the way up to career, as you're talking about. Mm-hmm. Why do you think it is important for Louisville's prosperity?
We can't achieve the economic prosperity we want without the workforce. And consumers and manufacturing have let us know that in many ways recently. I also happen to serve on the board of JCTC, and there we're working with manufacturers to create an educational course for advanced manufacturing in order to provide a workforce necessary for so many companies that are in Louisville and that are having trouble identifying qualified workers today.
So there are jobs.
There are jobs.
But maybe not the workforce.
The workforce
that we
isn't
need.
Ready for them. They don't mm-hmm. have the qualifications and the understanding yet that's necessary to be successful.
What kind of success stories are you hearing about the work Rotary does in this area?
Well, it's in a lot of ways. I think at this point, of course, we're early in this project. Students have gotten very excited, and the principals in the schools are very excited about the progress we're making. We're working as well. We're sponsoring a number of students to go through the Rotary Youth Leadership Academy every year. Which is a real opportunity for entering freshmen to learn about how to become leaders. And they're evolving in many of the high schools now to start Interact Clubs, which are Rotary's clubs for high school students, and provide leadership and service projects in their community. That's very exciting. We're seeing an increasing number of people expressing interest in remaining qualified for the scholarship. There are about 650 people per class ultimately. There's about 450 now. Both high schools are growing. And about 100 or so, a little more than 100 we project, would be eligible for the scholarship at the end of the four-year period.
Your resume certainly proves you're a person who believes in civic engagement. Mm-hmm. I mean, you've mentioned, a handful of things mm-hmm. that you do already. For young people who will be eligible for the scholarship, what do you say to them to inspire them to not just do this for themselves, but to engage in their community?
I think, on a personal level, it provides the opportunities to get to know people, to get to know your community and understand what's going on that I think is very rewarding on a very personal level. Externally, too, if you can help the community do better, you're going to be helping your family and you're going to be helping your friends and everyone else that you may know by helping the community do well, prosper, serve its citizenry well.
And I guess in some ways you're grooming a Rotary of the future.
We are, and we're hopeful that in the past, I think we've gotten a lot of Rotarians from various kinds of youth programs that clubs have sponsored, the Rotary Youth Exchange, for example. We have a lot of people that end up graduating into Rotary eventually because of their early experience.
All right. Well, thank you so much, Kevin, for coming to share this with us. It's exciting to see what you're doing. Thank you.
Thank you.